Fox 8 News at 4 o'clock. I'm Natalie Herbick.
And I'm Gabe Spiegel. Our top story, Browns owner Jimmy Haslam claims he didn't know anything about the multi-million dollar fraud scheme that sent 14 of his pilot Flying J executives to prison.
But today, a federal jury heard a secret recording that suggests Haslam not only knew his company was overcharging small trucking companies, but the Browns owner loved it. Fox 8's Tracy McCool joins us with the latest. Tracy.
Well, Gabe and Natalie, it is important to note that Jimmy Haslam has not been charged and denies any wrongdoing, but he is the CEO of Pilot Flying J, and the company admits it overcharged more than 5,000 customers and agreed to repay $85 million. And on the audio recording played today, one of his former executives says Haslam knew about the scheme for at least 5 years. Now, this jury heard Haslam's voice on a secret recording from a training session for Pilot Flying J employees, where the company's former vice president explained the fraud scheme. Haslam says, quote, "That sounds like Stick's old deal with Western." Now, John Stick Freeman was one of Haslam's sales executives who was caught overcharging a trucking company called Western Express, but Pilot Flying J agreed to make good by buying a broken down plane from the company for $1 million. In another recording played for the jury, Freeman said Haslam absolutely knew about the scheme the entire time because Freeman told him, and Haslam loved it because they still made almost $6 million off Western Express. Now, Fox 8 did reach out to the Browns, the NFL, Pilot Flying J for comment on the audio recording and how it could affect Jimmy Haslam's status as owner. NFL spokesperson Brian McCarthy says the league does not have any comment at this time, while NFL spokesman Joe Lockhart says he is not familiar enough with the trial to assess if Jimmy Haslam could face any discipline for the league. We have not heard back from the Browns or Pilot Flying J. In addition to the $85 million, Pilot Flying J paid in restitution to its customers. The company also paid $92 million in fines to allow it to remain in business. And again, Gabe and Natalie, Browns owner Jimmy Haslam is not facing any charges and denies any knowledge of the rebate scheme.